Headquarters in Santa Fe is now the first military installation in the country to have hydrogen as a backup plan if the power goes out. Now, if all goes well, it could be the start of something pretty big for the military. Action 7 News reporter Matt Grubbs joins us now live from Santa Fe with the story. Hey, Matt.
Hey, Shelley. Yeah, the military says one of their greatest weaknesses is that they're dependent on the power grid. In fact, all across the country, they're almost as reliant on it as the rest of us. The military is constantly considering things like vulnerability. Sometimes it's not being vulnerable to bullets and bombs, but to transformers and transmission lines. Electricity powers the U.S. military, but the government gets most of it just like the rest of us do. That's where hydrogen fuel cells come into the picture.
It took some bright people to envision it and to develop it for us to use it, which is no different from a complex car. And it's simple to drive.
The 8 hydrogen generators outside the National Guard headquarters in Santa Fe aren't that different from many other backup systems.
If the grid goes down, it's going to allow us to maintain our operations for emergency and any contingencies.
If power to the Guard headquarters is cut, the system kicks on. Hydrogen mixes with oxygen to generate electricity.
If it is fully loaded to 5 kilowatts, it'll run for about 12 hours.
There is one byproduct.
The only emissions from a hydrogen fuel cell process is actual water, clean water, actually. You could actually drink the water from this process.
Instead, the Guard says, the water drains away. Despite what we've all heard about hydrogen, the Army says it is safe.
If you spilled a gasoline or a kerosene or a liquid fuel, the vapors would collect along the ground and a spark could come and create a fire. Hydrogen vents so quickly that a fire is very unlikely.
It's safe, it's efficient, and it's easily renewable.
It's one more way the military plans to make itself less vulnerable. And the military also plans to monitor how things are going here at the New Mexico National Guard headquarters. If all goes well, this could become standard practice all across the country, even at U.S. military installations across the world. Live in Santa Fe, Matt Grubbs, KOAT Action 7 News.